I'm fine. Ma, I want to talk with you for 1 or 2 minutes after class. Ma?
Okay, sure.
Okay, thank you. Okay, let me begin by saying some of the beginning words.
Okay.
By Kunta Jin Fu Yuan Ling Ting. 各位尊敬的 Vaishnava Vaishnavi， 今天是2021年11月30日，我们又非常非常荣幸地邀请到了圣巴蒂维肯维纳纳斯哈斯瓦马拉什给我们讲解今天的大佛加瓦的童小课，敬请聆听。 Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupata Rubyascha Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavan Ebyo Vaishnavibyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the glorification of all the residents of Vrindavan. We heard about even the clouds in Vrindavan, that they're devotees. Then we heard about the rivers and the trees and the different plants. And then we heard about the cowherd boys. And we heard about the older gopi ladies, and then we heard about the younger gopi ladies, and now we're hearing about Srimati Radharani. So, we're also hearing about the competitor of the gopis, which is the flute. Yeah, the flute is a great competitor to the gopis because the flute is always enjoying the nectar from the lotus lips of Krishna. And when the flute not only enjoys the nectar from Krishna's lips, but he does it in such a way that he doesn't leave a drop of that nectar for anyone else. It doesn't matter how much the flute drinks, he always wants more. And he cannot stop drinking the nectar of Krishna's lips more and more. And the gopis, they've given up all material tastes. They have no interest in material life.
这些牧牛姑娘勾皮们, 他们对于物质生活，对于物质的品味是没有丝毫兴趣。
They have no interest in sense gratification, not only in this life, but in the next also. They're not attracted.
他们对于感官享乐也丝毫不感兴趣，无论是这一世还是来世，他们都对感官享乐没兴趣。
The only thing they're attracted to is the taste of the nectar from Krishna's lips.
唯一吸引木牛姑娘的就是 Krishna 唇上的甘露。
And the flute knows this, but the flute doesn't care. He drinks all the nectar of Krishna's lips himself.
这根笛子对此是一清二楚的，但是他根本就不在乎。把这些甘露呢全都独享了。
So we have to understand how fortunate this flute must be.
我们一定要理解这根笛子是太幸运了。
The rivers in Vrindavan, like the Yamuna, they purify all the worlds.By making arrangements for bathing and other different auspicious activities.
Vrindavan 境内的 Yamuna 河净化了所有三个世界，因为它提供给人们沐浴的场所，以及提供人们做其他吉祥活动的场所。
So these rivers are they're satisfied to get the remnants of the nectar that Krishna's lips leave behind.
所以，河流，他可能感到心满意足，因为他品尝到了 Krishna 的鼻子留下来的一些剩余的鲫鱼。
Right.Yeah, the nectar from Krishna's flute leaves a little bit of dry pulp.
Krishna 的鼻子，它留下了一些鲫鱼是什么呢？就是一些干巴巴的一些浆质的物质。
So people who know about the pastimes of Krishna.How they're described in poetry, they know about these rivers in Vrindavan.
那些精湛的诗人们，他们知道 Vrindavan 的河流对 Vrindavan 的河流一清二楚。
And they know how Krishna sometimes would come to these rivers with the gopis, and they would have water sports in the river.
他们知道 Krishna 会跟 Gopi 们在这个河流当中呢做水上的游戏，水上的娱乐。
And at that time, the rivers would get some of the nectar from Krishna's lips.
在这个时候呢，他就能得到Krishna 唇上的甘露了。
But of these rivers.One river is very special. That river is called Kalindi Devi, which is another name of the Yamuna.
在这些众多的河流当中，其中有一个河流叫 Kalindi Devi, 也就是杨的河的另一个名字，是独一无二的。
So Kalindi Devi is allowed. She is allowed to drink the nectar directly.
Kalindi Devi 被允许可以直接的喝饮这份甘露。
And the other rivers, they get the nectar from her.
而其他的河流只能从 Yamuna Kalindi Devi 那里得到一些鲫鱼。
And they get some nectar from her because they're also residing in the holy place of Krishna's pastimes.
之所以有机会得到这份鲫鱼，是因为他们也居住在 Krishna 上演消时光的地方。
So after they've tasted, if they get even a small drop of that nectar from Krishna's flute, then all the rivers feel so much bliss, they feel transcendental bliss.
品尝到哪怕是点点滴滴的甘露的鲫鱼之后，所有的河流也到了那极乐。
And in their bliss, their bodily hairs will stand on end.
他们感受到极乐后，他们身上会毛发直竖。
So the rivers become ecstatic just to get a drop of that nectar. So just think about the flute, how it must be so pious that he's able to drink as much nectar as he wants.
我们可以想象这根鼻子是多么的虔诚。 可以尽情地喝饮 Krishna 唇上的甘露。
So on the banks of the Yamuna River, there are some trees, special trees, like the pipala and other trees along the banks of the rivers in Vrindavan.
在河流的两岸生长着许多的树木。
And they provide fruit, they give shade to the people, and they also give some fruits. So these trees are like, they're like elders of a noble family.
这些树木就好像是一个贵族家庭的成员。Just
like in a family, there will be the senior people. They will do auspicious services for others.
这些树木就像家族的长辈，就好像在我们的家族当中，长辈们会为后代做很多的虔诚活动。But
these trees, they cry. And they're very unhappy because they cannot get the nectar from Krishna's lips. So we may wonder why the trees can't share the nectar.
我们可能纳闷, 为什么这些树木不能分享到点滴的甘露呢？
And we may think, oh, is it really possible that the trees will cry in disappointment?
我们可能会提出疑问，这些树木难道真的是失望的流下了眼泪了吗？
Just like a beggar, he may be sorry because he has nothing to eat.
就像一个乞丐，内心非常难过，因为他没有东西吃。But
he shouldn't worry that he can't rule a kingdom.
但他不应该为他不能统治王国而担心忧心忡忡。So
we can remove this doubt by knowledge that the trees of Vrindavan are Aryans, it means they're great saints. So these trees are actually great devotees of Lord Krishna.
这些树木实际上是 Krishna 的伟大的奉献者。
And they're very sad, and they cry when they don't get Krishna's nectar. But you could say also, they don't have any right to get it. They have no right to ask for Krishna's nectar. So these people who are crying in disappointment that they couldn't get the nectar, they're the mother, like the mothers-in-laws and other respectable elders of Radharani. Lord Krishna is the resort of all living entities. In Sanskrit, the word for this is Janani Vas. Janani Vas is one of the famous devotees in Mayapur who does the puja. There were two brothers, and one brother just died recently, a few months back, and the other brother is still here. He's Janani Vas. So Janani Vas is the name of Krishna. It means the ultimate resort of all living entities.
Janani Vas 这个词是 Krishna 的另外一个意思。
So Lord Krishna is also called the son of Devaki and the son of Yashoda. And he's the guide of the Yadu dynasty. And he kills everything inauspicious. And he will kill every man who is impious. Just by his presence, he destroys all the misfortune for all living entities. And by his blissful smile, he increases the lusty desires of the gopis. So may he be all glorious and happy. So this is described, this is how Lord Krishna is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam at the end of the 10th canto. So Maharaj Parikshit, he is reciting this also to his mother. And by glorifying Krishna, he also glorifies all the people of Gokula. So he wants to finish his speaking, and at the same time he wants to create auspiciousness. So he glorifies Lord Krishna by speaking the words of his own spiritual master, Sukadeva Goswami.
或重复他自己的灵性导师圣 Shukadev Goswami 的话来荣耀圣主 Krishna。
To give an example, just like Agastya Rishi, from his palm he could drink the whole salt ocean.
就像圣哲 Agastya Rishi, 他用 他的手掌就可以喝掉所有的海洋。
So Sukadeva Goswami spoke this verse of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
同样方式圣 Sukadeva Goswami 就引出了这首诗节。
He is attempting to drink from his own palm the whole ocean of Krishna's pastimes.
他以这种方式就是通过他自己的手掌来喝饮了圣主 Krishna 消时光的整个海洋。
Krishna's pastimes are all described in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam。
圣主 Krishna 的消时光在圣典国家瓦坛第十篇 有所描述。
So this verse was spoken by Sukadeva Goswami very near the end of the 10th canto。
这个诗节就是由圣 Sukadeva Goswami 在第十篇的几乎的最后末尾所讲述的。
And it's a summary of all the pastimes discussed in the whole 10th canto.
这个诗节就相当于圣典国家瓦坛第十篇的许多所有诗节的一个精华。
Yeah, in the 10th canto, there's several thousand verses.
第十篇有几千个诗节。
So in the verse that comes before this one, there's another verse which mentions Krishna and describes Krishna's glories.
在第十篇当中的就是末尾有许多的这个诗节呢就在圣典摩迦瓦坛的第十篇当中清晰地描述 Krishna 的那些诗节之前
So even though this verse doesn't mention Krishna by name, it is obvious it's about Krishna.
虽然这个诗节并没有指名道姓的提到 Krishna, 但是显而易见的它就是指的是 Krishna.
Just like Maharaj Parikshit was glorifying the different Brajbasis.Maharaj Parikshit was praising, he was glorifying all the different residents, the different living entities in Vrindavan.
就像 Parikshit 大君荣耀了 Vrindavan Raj, 那些 Rajabasi 的荣耀。
And he was glorifying them in a order of more importance, and he was coming to the most important one at the end, Srimati Radharani.
他是按照这些居民的重要程度的顺序来一一加以描述的，最重要的是 Srimati Radharani.
So Sukadeva Goswami tells us about six different aspects of Lord Krishna's special qualities.
Sukadeva Goswami 就依次讲述了圣主 Krishna 的特殊品质，有六项特殊品质。
And they go in increasing importance. One after one, the first one is not so much important, but then the last one is the most important.
这些品质呢，是按照他们的重要程度来加以一一描述的。第一个品质并不是那么重要，最后一个品质是最重要的。
So first one is that Krishna is the residence and the shelter and the foundation of all living beings.
首先，圣主 Krishna 是一切众生的居所。
And he's also the super soul within their hearts. And he's also manifest externally also among his favorite devotees. At that time, he will come in the form of his different incarnations. So he is the Supreme Brahman.
He's the
Supreme Atma, the Lord of all, and the seed of all avatars.
Krishna is the Supreme Atma,
All the avatars, they come from Krishna. Then the second quality is that Krishna displays the highest limit of his opulence in the world. It's the highest limit of his opulence in the words which he spoke to his father and mother at the time of his birth.
Krishna, 在他出生的时候, 他彬彬有礼地向他的父母, 讲述了一番话, 这番话语就展示了他的多重的富裕。
And he described the reason for his birth as their son.
他形容了他降生为他们儿子的原因。
And he also described his desire to be carried to Gokula.
在他出生的时候，他向父母表达了他希望被带到狗窟了的愿望。So Krishna
revealed to them the purpose of his coming in the world.
Krishna 向他父母揭示了他降临世的目的。And
he also proved that he was very generous in to give benedictions.
他也证实他在给予祝福方面是非常慷慨大度的。And
he gave them, and he was very compassionate and protective of his parents.
他对他的父母亲是心怀怜悯，他也保护了他的父母双亲。And
Krishna ordered his father Vasudev to carry him to Gokula.
Krishna 命令他的父亲 Vasudev 将他带到Gokula.
So by doing this, Krishna showed that he wanted to distribute everywhere the treasure of Krishna prema.
通过这番举动, Krishna 就表明了他希望他的宝藏发到每个角落。
Then the third thing was by having the most excellent Yadus as his companions and servants.
Krishna 的第三个品质是让优秀的卓越的Yadu族人成为他的同伴和他的仆人们。So
Krishna was demonstrating again the opulence of his appearance.
Krishna 再次展示了他显现的至尊的富裕。
Krishna put an end to the distress of his dear devotees, the Yadus.
Krishna 结束了他亲爱的亚度族人这些仆人们的痛苦。
And he made them happy by killing the wicked enemies of the Yadus. He killed people like Kamsa, Jarasandha. So Krishna showed how concerned he is for his devotees. And Krishna is always served by the exalted members of the Yadu dynasty. Yeah, the Krishna's always with the Yadu, the members of the Yadu dynasty. They're like an assembly.
Krishna 总是恒常的和亚度王朝的成员们生活在一起，这样呢，他们就好像是一个聚会，一个聚会团体。
When Krishna was on the planet, he brought down to earth the special Sudharma assembly hall. He brought it down from the heavenly planets because it was the demigods' hall. And Krishna made this a court for the king of the Yadus, who is Ugrasena. So Krishna had brought this hall down from the heavenly planets, and he also brought the Parijata flower from the heavenly planets.
Krishna 不仅将这个议事大厅带到地球，他还将天堂上的 Parijata 树木也带到了地球。And
to do this, Krishna had to defeat the demigods.
为此，他要击败那些半人们。
And this way Krishna showed his supreme power and his opulence. So by giving that assembly hall to Ugrasena, who is the father of Kamsa, Ugrasena was the father of the enemy Kamsa, but Krishna showed his kindness. Although Ugrasena is the father of a demon like Kamsa, Krishna gave him the royal assembly hall. So Krishna showed his very kind to everyone.
虽然乌格森呢是Krishna的敌人，汤萨的父亲，但是。乌格森不是Krishna的敌人，他是Kamsa，他的儿子Kamsa是Krishna的敌人。
Yes, I'll say it again. Krishna's, he doesn't have prejudice towards people. He's equal to everyone. So then the fourth thing is that Krishna could have removed all the irreligion simply by his own will. He could have taken away all the irreligion from the planet.
Krishna 地球上的所有非宗教从地球上移除。
But instead, Krishna created very nice pastimes for his devotees by killing the demons who opposed him.
但是 Krishna 却通过杀死这些敌对的对手们，为他的奉献者创造了一个非常令人愉悦的消食光。
Yeah, the demons always oppose religion.
这些恶魔们总是反对宗教。
So, but Krishna killed them, and but he used his mighty arms, which were beautifully shaped, with and ornamented, and Krishna had these arms hold different weapons, like his Sudarshan Chakra, and he used that Sudarshan Chakra to kill these different.Demons.
Krishna 有着修长的、优雅的臂膀，上面佩戴着手镯和臂环。他手持像神碟这样的武器。Krishna 就用这他修长的、强有力的臂膀啊，杀死了那些宗教的邪恶对手。
So there's.One scripture describes about Krishna's battle with Banasura, when Krishna was fighting with this demon Banasura. At that time, such enemies, Krishna would sometimes, just for the pleasure of his devotees, he would manifest four arms instead of two.
经典中，就描述说，当 Krishna 和巴纳摩作战的时候，Krishna， Maharaj，
Krishna would manifest four arms instead of two.
Okay， 在 Krishna 跟巴纳摩作战的时候，他展示了他的四臂。而不是展示的是他的两臂来和巴纳摩作战。
Yeah, and he would do this just to give pleasure to some special devotees.
他这么做是为了给一些奉献者带来特殊的快乐。
Okay, then, Sukadeva Goswami was talking about Krishna's arms, so we want to understand the significance of Krishna's arms.
Sukadeva Goswami, 他这时候他就提到了 Krishna 的臂膀，所以我们要理解 Krishna 臂膀的重要意义。
And so another point about Krishna's arms is that.The devotees who assist Krishna, like the Pandavas, that they acted like Krishna's arms.
那些 Krishna 的手，比如说 Krishna 潘达的五兄弟，他们就好像是 Krishna 的左膀右臂一样。
So Krishna used these Kshatriyas, and the Kshatriyas they're born from Krishna's arms.
Krishna 使用了这些 Kshatriya， 他们是生于 Krishna 的臂膀。
So the Kshatriyas were engaged to kill the envious demons who opposed Krishna's and who opposed the practice of religion.
这些 Kshatriya， 他们被用来杀死那些邪恶之敌以及。杀死那些反对宗教力量的敌人。
Now, Krishna, simply by his desire, he could have killed demons like Jarasandha.
Krishna 本来可以仅仅靠他的意志就杀死像 Jarasandha 这样的敌人。
And he could have done the same. He could have killed all the other wicked kings who opposed him just by his desire.
他也可以仅仅凭借他的欲望就杀死那些反对他的敌人们。
But Krishna's like a father, and he liked to share his fame along with his devotees.
Krishna 就如慈父一般，把希望和他的奉献者们享受分享他的荣耀。
So he used people like Arjuna and Bhima and that to kill different demons.
Krishna 便使用了像 Arjuna 和 Bhima 这样的人来杀死那些敌人。
All right, so that's the fourth thing. Now the fifth thing is about enjoying his pastimes in Gokula.
刚才说到的是第四点，第五点就是有关于他在 Gokula 的享受逍遥时光的事情。
In Gokula, Krishna showed the mood of loving devotional service.
Krishna 在 Gokula 展示了他爱心的奉爱服务这件事。
Of course, the pastimes in Mathura and Dwarka, they took place after Krishna's pastimes in Gokula.
在 Mathura 和 Dwarka这两个地方上演的逍遥时光是在 Gokula 之地上演逍遥时光之后发生的。
But here, it's the other way around. We already spoke about Dwarka and Mathura. Now we're speaking about Gokula.
在前面已经说到了 Mathura 和 Dwarka， 现在轮到了 Gokula。
Because Krishna is the most perfect in Gokula, and his pastimes are the most relishable.
Krishna 在 Gokula 是最完美的，而且在 Gokula 的逍遥时光是最令人津津乐道的。
And Krishna gave prema bhakti to all the people of Vrindavan.
Krishna 将 prema bhakti 赐予了 Vrindavan 的全体居民们。
Even to the non-moving beings, such as the creepers and the bushes and trees, they got Krishna prema.
甚至对那些不能移动的生物体，诸如爬藤、灌木和树木，他也赐予了他们 prema bhakti.
And of course, all the moving creatures, they also got prema bhakti. Even the insects and the microbes.
当然了。所有能会移动的生物体也得到了 prema bhakti， 比如说那些昆虫和微生物。
He didn't consider their qualification.
Krishna 并不考虑他们是否有资格。
He gave them the gift of loving devotion to him.
他把对他的爱心服务当作礼物送给他们。
And that destroys all material existence.
这就能够摧毁所有物质存在。
So just as happiness is available in heaven, but that's not good for people who want liberation.
就像在天堂上可以得到种种感官享乐。这对于那些希望得到解脱的人们是不利的。
The happiness of liberation, that it's an impediment for people who want to serve Krishna.
而解脱的快乐，对于那些希望对 Krishna 做奉爱服务的人们而言，又是同样是一种障碍。
That is actually the happiness of liberation is so-called happiness. It's actually an obstacle.
解脱的快乐是所谓的被称为是所谓的快乐，因为它实际上是一个障碍。
So Krishna destroys for the devotees. He destroys that illusion of happiness of liberation.
Krishna 为他的奉献者摧毁了这种解脱带来的虚幻快乐。
All the devotees who are attracted to him in Vrindavan, And anywhere in Brajabhumi, they get that special mercy of Krishna. Yeah. Krishna gives his prema bhakti to everybody all over Vrindavan.
Krishna 就将 prema bhakti 赐予了文达文所有的居民们。
Whether it doesn't matter if they're moving or not moving, living entities, they all get prema bhakti.
无论是移动还是不移动的居民们，他们全都得到 prema bhakti。
So they don't experience the miseries of material entanglement.
他们就没有体验到了物质束缚的带来的痛苦。
And they have no interest in impersonal liberation.
这些文达文居民对非人格的解脱丝毫不感兴趣。
So when Krishna increased Krishna increased the Krishna prema in Vrindavan. He gave more and more prema to the people in Vrindavan.
Krishna 在 Vrindavan 他给予了越来越多的 prema.
So all the people in the three worlds, they got freed of the unhappiness of the material world.
所有全世界的生物都摆脱了物质存在的痛苦。
To give an example, just like when you light a fire to do cooking, so the heat from the fire takes away the cold and the darkness.
打一个比方，像在做饭时候升起了灶火，那个灶火同时又驱散了黑暗，驱散了寒冷。
In the same way, by giving Krishna bhakti to the people of Vrindavan, it freed all the living beings from material miseries.
以同样方式，通过赐予 Vrindavan 的 prema bhakti, 就驱散了所有众生的物质痛苦。
And when Krishna appeared in Gokula, when Krishna appeared on this planet Gokula, He freed all the devotees throughout the universe.
When Krishna 降临 Gokula 的的时候，他就把全世界
freed all the devotees throughout the universe. He freed them from material miseries.
Krishna 就把所有世界所有世界的奉献者的物质痛苦，从他们将这些物质痛苦当中拯救出来了。
And they had no more attraction to liberation.
使得他们对于解脱，就失去了吸引。
That liberation would be easy for them. Just like yogis have mystic powers, so devotees are all liberated.
就像瑜伽师们，他们都有那些玄秘力量，所有的这些，文达文的居民们，他们也自动的就得到了解脱。
So this was the result of giving Krishna prema in Vrindavan.
这就是在文达文给予 Krishna prema 所带来的结果。
So the devotees all over the universe were free from material miseries.
宇宙当中所有的奉献者们，这样一来就摆脱了物质的苦恼。
But the people, the devotees living in Vrindavan, during Krishna's pastimes, they got the biggest relief.From material entanglement.
而在 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 生活在文达的那些奉献者，在 Krishna 的消失光当中生活在文达的奉献者，他们是从物质的痛苦当中得到救赎，从这个角度来说，他们是最大程度的摆脱了物质的痛苦。
Okay, so now this is the sixth thing which is the most important.
现在是第六点，也就是最重要的一点。
And this is how Krishna revealed his greatest glory, and that was his wonderful beauty and charm.
Krishna 就展示了他的最高的荣耀，也就是他的美丽、俊美以及他的魅力。
And also Krishna's cleverness.
以及 Krishna 的聪颖。
Especially in his pastimes with the young gopis of Vrindavan.
尤其是他在跟文达的那些年轻姑娘的消时光当中展示出来的。
So when Krishna was present in Vrindavan, then it was like an opulent city.
当 Krishna 临在于文达文的时候，文达文就好像一座富裕的城市。
And there were many, of course, Krishna performed many different pastimes, and he had also his romance with the gopis.
当然了 ，Krishna 上演了不同的消时光，他也和牧牛姑娘之间也有恋情。
So Krishna's smiling face, and he's holding his flute, and wearing different ornaments.Attract the women in Vrindavan. They were all attracted to him.
Krishna 的可爱的笑脸 ，Krishna 吹奏笛子的样子，以及 Krishna 的各种装饰物，都深深吸引了文达文的女士们。
There's a god of love. The god of love is called Kamadev.
爱神。名字就叫 Kamadev.
So, this god of love, he is very radiant, very effulgent.
爱神呢，他是浑身散发着熠熠的光彩。
And the beauty of Krishna's face, it gives Kamadev power.Over the gopis.
'Kamadeva,
the god of love. So the beauty, because of Krishna's beautiful face, the god of love, Kamadev, he gets powers over the gopis.
Okay. 就 Krishna 的面庞的美丽是使得 Kamadev 使得爱神拥有无穷无尽的力量来
over the gopis
赐予也使得 gopi 们获得了力量。
That power it defeats the attraction of material life.
这个力量就击败了物质生活所带来的吸引力
，and takes away even the attraction of liberation.
它甚至拿走了解脱对人们的吸引。
So Cupid is famous for spoiling the interests of everyone he influences.
Cupid,
the god of love, is famous because he ruins the interests of everyone. When he influences people in love, then their interests, their real self-interests become ruined.
Okay. 爱神呢，他非常的著名，因为当爱神降临的时候呢，他就使得受爱神影响的那些人们。他们对他们的自我利益都失去了。
But that doesn't happen with the gopis of Vrindavan.
但是这一点呢,
For the gopis of Vrindavan, Cupid destroys the material existence, the attraction to material existence.
相反,
And Cupid helps the gopis bring Krishna under their control.
不仅如此，爱神还帮助狗品们去控制了主Krishna。
And he arranges for them the different forms of liberation and devotion.
他为他们安排了解脱的不同形式以及奉爱的不同形式。
So Cupid arranges for the gopis to realize Krishna.
爱神丘比特就为勾比们做出安排来觉悟Krishna.
And to understand his full glory and to enjoy his company.
来帮助他们觉悟Krishna的荣耀, 享受Krishna.
So attraction, we want to develop attraction for Krishna like in the mood of the gopis. That attraction which the gopis have for Krishna, we could call it Kama Deva, we could call it the God of all love.
对，在勾皮的心绪当中被 Krishna 深深吸引，我们可以称之为 Kama Deva， 也就是爱的一切爱的神旨。The
best form of that love is what focuses on Krishna.
那种爱的最好的形式就是专全神贯注于 Krishna。
So that kind of love is very rare. We have to develop that. It's the purest state of love. So, because the gopis and Krishna, they enjoy pastimes together. Pastimes are very intimate, and the gopis enjoy the beauty of Krishna. And when they come together, it's like play. There's a lot of it seems like material enjoyment. Because the gopis are so enjoying the beauty of Krishna's face. The beauty of Krishna's face affects the gopis, and that delights Krishna. It causes the gopis to forget the four goals of life.
它使得牧牛姑娘们忘记了生命当中的四项目标。And
instead, the gopis come to the highest level of prema.
勾皮们反而达到了最高的 prema 的层面。And
that's a fruit of all devotional endeavors.
那是所有勾皮们 更爱的努力的成熟结果。
So in this way, Krishna's smiling represents the ultimate greatness of the Supreme Person.
Krishna 的笑容就代表了他的最高的他的最伟大之处。
He is the most charming, the most beautiful, and he is most expert in loving affairs.
在爱的恋情方面 ，Krishna 是最有魅力的，他最美丽的，以及他最擅长的。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
那好，我们今天的正课部分就讲到这里。接下来我们看一下问题。第一个问题是，Ina 说 ，Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisance. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. In the second chant of Srimad Bhagavatam, it tells how Brahma performed austerities and obtained knowledge. Could Gurudev explain what is the relationship between knowledge and austerities, and how we can apply austerities to get knowledge? Yuna 的问题是 Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and 奉献者们，现在奉献者请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有荣耀归于圣巴巴的。在圣女不教法堂的第二篇就讲述了 Rama 他是怎么从事苦修的，并且获得了知识。 Gurudev 能不能解释一下知识和苦行之二者之间的关系，以及我们怎么能够运用苦行来获得知识呢？
Okay, so austerity means to minimize the demands of the body.
苦行的意思就是减少躯体的要求。
And when you minimize the demands of the body, then you'll understand how much you're in control of your mind and senses.
当一个人他降低了自己躯体的要求需求的时候，他就能够明白，可以控制他对于感官，控制感官，控制心意方面，他得到多少进步。
So, when you do austerity, you come to understand more that you're not the body, that you're a spirit soul.
当您从事苦行的时候，您就能明白，您不是这个躯体，也不。而是灵魂。
And you will come to understand how difficult it is to control your mind and senses.
你也能够领会到要控制感官、控制心意是多么困难的一件事。
So, by doing austerity, you awaken this kind of realization. That is knowledge.
通过苦行就能唤醒这种觉悟，被称之为知识。
The more you do chanting and you stop material activities, then the more you'll become awakened in transcendental knowledge.
你越是念诵，越是停止那些物质的活动，就越能唤醒超然的知识。
So you want to...Everyone should do some austerity.
每个人都想从事某种苦行。
Austerity means also it's one of the pillars of religion. There are four pillars of religion. One is austerity.
宗教有四个支柱，其中一个支柱就是苦行。
So austerity is destroyed. One thing which destroys austerity.Is pride. People are very proud. They don't want to do austerity.
苦行就被骄傲所毁灭，人们不想从事苦行。
If we ask people to sit on the floor, they don't want to do it. They say, "I'm not going to." They say, "I'm not going to sit on the floor." They don't like to bow down. They go in the temple, you ask them to bow down. They don't like to bow down. I'm not going to bow before someone. They're so proud. So, austerity is the wealth of people in the renounced order of life. So austerity is especially meant for the renounced people. If you're renounced, then you need to do more austerity. And by doing austerity, we purify our existence because we're controlling the mind and senses. And this helps us to awaken transcendental knowledge. By doing austerity, you'll attract the mercy of devotee. And from the mercy of the devotees, they'll give you transcendental knowledge. Just like on Ekadasis, we're supposed to minimize the demands of the body. So when we minimize the demands of the body, then we have more time to hear and to chant. By doing more hearing and chanting, you awaken more transcendental knowledge. Okay. Any other question?
Yes. 下一个问题是舒提如法对达斯。 Hare Krishna, 礼拜Guru和老师们，请教Guru两个问题。有修佛的法师现在开始修学Krishna知觉，他提问，在进行神像崇拜的时候，有没有对法器的冥想，或者是手势、高度等具体的要求？ 还是只是想着Krishna就可以了呢？So there are two questions from Shri Rupa Devadasi. Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru and teachers. The first question is that now there is a Buddhist priest who has become to practice Krishna consciousness. Her question is that when we worship deities, are there any demand about if we should meditate on the...
When you worship deities,
yes, then when we worship the deities, should we meditate on those conch or those chamara and fans, like this paraphernalia? Or are there any demand, detailed demand about the height and the gesture of the deity worship and of Gaudu?
No.
Or only if we think about Krishna, that is okay.
Yes, that's the main point, that you think of Krishna. And you, just like we hear about Krishna, and so we think about Krishna, first of all, we offer prayers to Krishna by chanting his name. That's the first thing.
Krishna. 就像当我们聆听 Krishna 的时候，我们自然的就想到 Krishna。我们也通过就唱诵 Krishna 的名字来向 Krishna 祈祷。
Before you worship the deity, first of all, you should chant the holy name of Krishna.
在开始神像崇拜之前，应当唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
If you're not chanting the holy name of Krishna, then you're not qualified to worship the deity of Krishna.
如果不唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，就没有资格来崇拜 Krishna 的神像。
So you have to chant the holy name. And by chanting the holy name of Krishna properly, then naturally we will come to remember Krishna's form and qualities and pastimes.
所以需要通过唱诵圣名来获得这个资格，就当人们正确的唱诵 Krishna 的圣名的时候，自然而然的他们会联想起 Krishna 的形象、品质、消失光。
We hear the pastimes of Krishna. We hear them. We've been talking about them this morning.
我们聆听 Krishna 的消失光，就像今天的早课，我们谈到了 Krishna 的消失光。
So when we chant the holy name, we will remember more of these pastimes.
当我们唱诵 Krishna 的名字的时候，我们就能更多的联想到 Krishna 的消失光。
Okay.
第二个问题，有新人认真阅读佛教梵歌。对其中内容感兴趣，但是无法相信 Krishna 是个大活人。他让我向他证明 Krishna 是活生生的一个人。请问 Guru 该怎么做呢？感恩。One new faculty read Bhagavad Gita very seriously. After that, he or she is interested in the contents of Bhagavad Gita, but cannot believe that Krishna is actually a living person. He want me to prove to him that Krishna is a living person. Guru, what should I do? Thank you.
Well, you can simply tell him that the place where Krishna lived is there. You can go to visit the place of Krishna, where Krishna was born.You can see the place where Krishna was born. You can see the places where Krishna performed his pastimes. And you can see the hill that Krishna picked up. So how can you say? And then we have also so many deities of Krishna, and they're all made exactly like Krishna. So how can he say Krishna is not a person? He may not believe. That's his problem. What does he believe? He doesn't believe Krishna. That's his faith, because although we're telling him of everything about Krishna, we're describing about Krishna's life, and still he's not believing, then how can we help a person like that? He's useless.
您可以告诉他，就是 Krishna 住的地方就在那里，然后请他去拜访 Krishna 的住的地方啊，他的出生地，去亲眼去看看，然后 Krishna 从事上演那个消失光的地方，看看 Krishna 当年举起的高然山。除此之外呢，就是 Krishna 还有许许多的神像。这些神像都跟 Krishna 的那种模样是一模一样的，那怎么能又说 Krishna 不是一个活生生的人呢？那如果这位新人他自己不相信的话，是他自己的问题。那他不信 Krishna， 他信什么呢？就是您可以报告，就是我们已经讲述了 Krishna 有关 Krishna 的一切 ，Krishna 的形象 ，Krishna 的生活。如果他不信，那又怎么能帮助他呢？那就没有用了。
So he's read the Bhagavad Gita. You could give him the Krishna book to read, let him read the Krishna book. It's all about the life of Krishna.
You
can read about Krishna's birth, what happened at Krishna's birth. You can read about Krishna's life, how he grows up. Okay, so you let him read the Krishna book. But it sounds to me like this person, he's just an atheist. He doesn't believe in anything. He doesn't like to believe. He doesn't have faith. So you tell him in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes in the seventh chapter, Krishna describes four kinds of people who never surrender to him. So ask him which one of the four is he? But then if he keeps reading, the next verse goes on to describe four kinds of people who do surrender to him. Anyway, you know, you try to give him prasadam, ask him to chant the holy name of Krishna. Try to help him. Okay.
下一个问题是来自于杨洋，顶拜孤的莲花组，顶拜莲，清晨早起念十六圈，在念诵的时候总在胡思乱想，内心总想专注，都控制不住，有时躯体有病，特别障碍，有时候对自己不专注，特别焦虑。请问孤主，我该怎么从焦虑当中稳定下来呢？ So Yang, he or she pay obeisance to Lotus Feet. And when I get up early morning and chant my 16 rounds, I cannot control my mind. I cannot be attentive. Sometimes there are disease, bodily disease, and it is obstacle also. And also I'm very worried about my inattentiveness in chanting. So Guru, how can I be very steady among, although I have so many anxiety, how can I be very steady in my chanting?
Well, you have to keep chanting. That's the first thing. You don't give up, you keep chanting. You have to be determined. That I'm going to keep chanting, and gradually your mind will become steady, your mind will accept. You have not been chanting for very long.
您那个念诵的时间还不长。So
it's going to take your mind some time to get adjusted that this is what you're going to do every day.
那您的心意就会慢慢得到调整，您就告诉您的心意，这是您每天都要做的事儿。
Just like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, the mind can be the friend or the mind can be the enemy. You have to conquer the mind. Make the mind your friend. Get it to do what you want. So it's training our mind to be submissive, to get it to do what the soul wants. Don't give it freedom. The mind will always resist. It has that tendency in the beginning. It resists. Oh no, don't chant. The mind will say, don't chant, don't do this. The mind is objecting. But you have to be convinced that this is what you have to do.
让心意服从，就让心意去做灵魂想做的事情，灵魂的心意去做什么，让心意去做。然后那个一开始呢，心意总是拒绝的，就是说，哎呀，不要念诵了，别做这件事，他就会提出种种反对的声音。但是您要对自己要所做的事情要满怀信心。
So when you make up your mind that this is what you're going to do, then the mind will surrender.
当您就是下定决心的时候，告诉心意这就是你一定要做的事，然后心意就会成熟了。
Okay, yeah.
下一个是 Mayapur Lila Devadasi， 禀拜Guru，请问有奉献者离开妻子，与另一个帕布到农村生活，过简朴的生活，夫妻长期分居，也不履行照顾家庭及妻子的职责，这样的生活方式对吗？这样做能唤醒他的 Krishna 之觉吗？作为妻子能怎么办呢？再问一下Guru，自己的念珠可以被别人触碰吗？ Obeisant Guru, my question is that there is who left his wife and go to the countryside to live with another Prabhu. Together they live a very simple life. And since the couple separated for a long time, and he didn't carry out her duty to take care of the family and the wife. Is this lifestyle right or wrong?
That's not good. It's certainly not good.
一定不好.
If you have a wife and family, you have to take care of them.
他有自己的妻子和家庭，他需要照顾。At
a certain point in the life, you can do that. If you're in older age, and the children are grown up, and they can take care of themselves, then you can do that.
在生命的特定的阶段，当人进入老年了，孩子都长大成人了，可以照顾自己的时候，在这个时候是可以这么做的。
But if the children are young, they need to be taken care of. They need to have their father there.
孩子还小的时候呢，是需要父亲照顾的，需要父亲在身边。
So we should not be irresponsible. We should be responsible, take care of people who are dependent on us.
我们不应该做一个不负责任的人，对那些依赖我们的人们，我们不理不睬。
嗯哼。
So she continued to ask, and this kind of lifestyle awaken his Krishna consciousness, and what should his wife do?
Can that kind of life help his Krishna consciousness? Well, I don't know. Who told him to do this, first of all? He should act under the instructions of a spiritual teacher. Did a spiritual teacher tell him to go and do that? You don't become Krishna conscious just by going away from the family. That's not good. I think the wife and family, they may have to go and live with them in the forest. Sometimes people think that they become very spiritual by going away from the home, but sometimes they do that just to get the respect of others, just for their own false ego.
有的人误以为就是离开远离家庭，他们就更灵性化了。那他们这么做，实际上是为了得到人们的尊敬，实际上是他们的假我在那里作祟。
If he would stay at home, he can make his wife and children Krishna conscious. But he's gone away from home, he's not looking after their Krishna consciousness.
可是他现在离家，离开家庭了，他就没有帮助他的家人。
Even though the wife may not be interested, but still, if we have family, we have children, we have a duty, we have a responsibility.
即便是妻子不感兴趣的话，那她仍然是有家的，是有家庭的人，也是有孩子的人，那么她就。
So we don't encourage that kind of behavior.
She asked, can we let others to touch our chanting beads?
Yes, if you want, but why? Why you have to let others touch your chanting beads? Let them touch their own chanting beads.
可以，如果您愿意想这么做的话，是可以的。但是原因理由是什么呢？他们应当这些人应该碰他们自己的念珠。
Of course, it's up to every individual for yourself. If you want them to touch your beads, you can let them. You don't have to. I personally don't let people touch my beads. The important thing is the holy name, the chanting of the holy name. It's not the beats which are important. It's the holy name. I was just a short time ago, we had Prabhupada's disappearance festival, and we were celebrating the day in which Prabhupada left the world. So I was hearing one devotee speak. This one devotee was describing how he'd been the servant of Prabhupada.
就在不久之前，我们庆祝了圣帕帕德的隐居日。然后我听一个奉献者，他是说话讲话，他是圣帕帕德的仆人。So
he was describing how he was when he was serving Prabhupada, he remembered that he'd lost his initiation beads. So he asked Prabhupada. He said, "Prabhupada, he said, you know, the beads which you gave me when I got initiation, somehow they got taken by somebody else. I lost them." So he said, "Could you chant on my new beads for me?"
这个奉献者呢，他是帕帕德的仆人，他就说，他形容说，当他服务帕帕德的期间呢，他把自己的念起笛念珠给弄丢了，就有人把这他的念珠给拿走了，然后这个仆人呢就问帕帕德说，他告诉他说，帕帕德，你能不能在我的新念珠上念诵呢？And
Prabhupada said to him, he said, "I have given you the holy name. That's enough. You just chant on the beads yourself. You don't need me to chant on them. You chant the holy name yourself." I said, "I've given you, when I initiated you, I gave you the holy name. Now you chant."
圣帕帕德的回答是说，我已经把圣名给你了，这就足够了。你自己在你的念珠上念诵，我已经把圣名给在起碟的时候给了你圣名，现在呢，你就自己去念诵。
Okay, yes.
下一个问题是来自于 Radha Nanda Devadasi. Hare Krishna 显见到什么人也不是随便便，也不是随随便便的，得具备一定的资格。别说想见习主席了，一个平民百姓想见党委书记容易吗？没有恰当的事由和身份，普通人不能想见谁是见谁，所以我们得有自知之明。 想见至尊主，这个人格舍神就是真理控制者，众生的至尊父亲是 Krishna， 并不是很难取得符合见 Krishna 的资格，自然就能见到。当我们具备了判断五兄弟的品质，不需要我们求见，至尊主会自动来见我们的 Hare Krishna。 The Radhananda Mataji, this is a comment about the last question about that the new fight he asked the monk to see Krishna.
Yeah.
Should I translate that?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. It's not an ordinary thing to see others. One has to got qualification. Is it an easy thing to No, we don't mention that President Xi, even an ordinary local government leaders, it's not easy to see him. If one don't have the reason to see him or the qualification to see him, the ordinary person cannot demand to see whoever he wants. So we have to know ourselves now. Well, if we want to see the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Absolute Truth, the Absolute Controller, the Father of the Supreme Father, the Supreme Lord Krishna, it's not a difficult thing. We should have the qualification, and we can naturally see Lord Krishna when we as qualified as Pandavas. And we have that qualification. We don't need to demand to see Krishna. Lord Krishna will personally volunteer to see us. Hare Krishna. This is her comment.
Okay. Yes, Prabhupada's spiritual master used to say like that.
是的，圣帕帕德的灵性导师常常这么说。
He would say, "Don't try to see Krishna, but act in a way that Krishna will come to see you."
他说，不要试图去见 Krishna, 而是要让您自己的行为举止使得 Krishna 来见我们。
One devotee described, he said, he was always looking for a guru, and then he heard about Prabhupada. He said that the people told him that, he said, this guru, he can show you God. He can show you, he can actually show you God. So the devotee thought, wow, he thought, oh, I want to see God. So he thought, I'm going to go to this guru, and I'll get him to show me God. So when he went to see Prabhupada, the first thing Prabhupada said was, don't try to see God, but act in a way that God will come and see you.
就是曾经奉献者们形容说，就是曾经有一个人呢，他在寻找一位guru，然后呢，别的人就告诉他说，圣帕帕德可以把神展示给你。 然后呢，这个奉献想见神的人呢，他想要看见神，然后想要找guru的人呢，他就来了。然后呢，他见到帕帕的时候，帕帕第一句话就是说：“你不要试图见神，你要这么去做事情，好让神来见你。”
So, Prabhupada was training us from the beginning. What should be our mood?
帕帕德从一开始就训练我们，我们的正确心态是什么？
The mood should be give service. You first serve Krishna. Don't, I want this, I have to see that. And first you serve, you do service, then Krishna will reveal himself to you.
心态是什么呢？就是去服务，服务的心态。你要去服务 Krishna， 然后你的行为举止，就是应当去做服务，使得 Krishna 可以愿意把他自己揭示给想见他的那个人。
In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "As you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly."
在佛家梵歌当中，Krishna说，我按照一个人的臣服程度给予相应的回报。
So if you have not surrendered, don't expect to get any reward.
所以，倘若没有臣服的话，就不要指望得到Krishna的回报了。Okay,
Shaikh, you want to?
还有一个问题是 Vivo 93。 顶拜咕噜和奉献者们，为了念诵时不想太多杂念，养成听课时念；咕噜讲英语时念诵圣名，翻译时聆听，这样也不对，是吗？ So this devotee said that obeying to guru and devotees in order to chant without so many thoughts. That I have the cultivated habit to chant while listening to the lecture. When Guru speaks English, I will chant the holy name. And when the translate, I will listen. Is this right? Is this also not right? This is not right.
Well. Well, it's certainly if you were with Prabhupada, when Prabhupada went to India, he brought the devotees with him. So sometimes Prabhupada would lecture. He would lecture in the local language. He would speak the Indian language, and he would give the class, and the devotees couldn't understand. But Prabhupada said, you have to sit. He said, even though you don't understand, he said, this is spiritual. He said, and you'll get purified by hearing it.
就当年呢，圣帕拉德就带了门徒就去一起去印度，然后他讲课的时候会用当地的语言，用印地语讲课，然后贡献者们呢听不懂印地，但是圣帕拉德告诉他们，那即便你们听不懂，你们应当坐在那里，听不懂灵性导师的说话，但是灵性导师的这个印证就能净化灵听者。
So there is spiritual potency. Don't take it to be material. It's a spiritual sound vibration.
So, 灵导师的讲话是有灵性力量的，不要把它当成是物质的。这个音阵是灵性的音阵。
Of course, you're chanting the holy name. That's also spiritual.
那当然。 您念诵圣名，这也是一个灵性的活动。
Okay.
He continued to ask, 心意、智性、假我之间的关系，偶尔再讲一下好吗？ 心意、智性、支配自、智、前两者决定假我的大小吗？心意、支配、智性、前两者决定假我的大小。 Can you explain in detail the relationship between mind, 自性, mind and both ego. Can you explain the relationship between mind and both ego? The mind dominates over Atma, and the mind and Atma decide the scale of the false ego. Because he mentioned that 自性, I don't understand this word, this term, 自性.
Is he online?
那个 Vivo 93，这位奉献者您在线吗？ 不然您就开麦来讲一下，解释一下自性，解释，因为我不明白您这个自性是什么。哦，can we move on to the next question?
Yeah.
下一个是我们先问一下柴灯，回答柴灯的常用问题。 Hare Krishna, invite Gurudev, 奉献者们，请问梵歌第四章超人知识属于 Gyana Yoga 第四章加在第三章和第五章业报与价值间有什么联系呢？ Vidyanacharya said, Hare Krishna, basis to Gurudev and devotees. The fourth chapter of Bhagavad Gita is transcendental knowledge, and does this belong to Gyana Yoga? And also the fourth chapter is between chapters three and five. What's the relationship between them?
Okay. So no, Jnana Yoga, it doesn't, transcendental knowledge doesn't really belong to Jnana Yoga. Transcendental knowledge, but there's also in bhakti, there's also transcendental knowledge.
超然知识就不属于Jnana Yoga，思辨瑜伽，就是奉bhakti奉爱，它是超然的。The
final section of the Bhagavad Gita, chapters 13 to 18, they're more on Jnana Yoga.
佛家梵歌的最后一部分就是十三章到第十八章，他们就属于Jnana Yoga 思辨瑜伽.
And they describe more. It describes more there about the modes of nature, and how the modes of nature are acting on individuals, on everything we do. So that is Jnana Yoga.
其中就涉及到了物质自然三形态的内容，以及物质自然三形态是怎么影响我们的行动，就这些都是这属于Jnana Yoga。Jnana Yoga
also will focus more on the impersonal Brahman.
Jnana Yoga它的关注重点着重在非人格的Brahman，非人格的梵。
So, the third chapter of Bhagavad Gita is Karma Yoga, and then the fifth chapter is Karma Yoga action in Krishna consciousness. So there's the relationship. You see, the third chapter, Lord Krishna is describing Karma Yoga, but Karma Yoga, generally people who do Karma Yoga, they don't have much knowledge, they don't know anything. They just work in a detached way. But because it...
Sorry,
Yeah, they're attached to work. They're attached to working, and they give the result. They may give the result of their work to Krishna.
这些人他们特别依附特定的工作，然后他们就把工作结果拿出来给Krishna。
But people may do Karma Yoga, they may give the result to other things, they may give the result to some other god, they may not just give it to Krishna, they may give it to some demigod.
Sorry, Mara, I clarified that the fifth chapter is that the people do Karma Yoga and they give the result to Krishna, not in the Karma Yoga. The third chapter,
Yeah, they give the result, but they may not give it to Krishna. They may do Karma Yoga, they may be detached from the result, but they may give the result to some demigod. Karma Yoga is just working with detachment. You do your duty, but you're detached from the result.
Karma Yoga 呢，就是你履行职责，然后不依附结果。
So, Karma Yogis they don't have much knowledge.
那些 Karma Yogi. 活动瑜伽的瑜伽师，他们没有很多的知识。
So therefore, the fourth chapter, Krishna speaks transcendental knowledge.
因此 ，Krishna 到了第四章呢，就开始讲述超然的知识了。
And he describes his own transcendental position.
Krishna 在第四章描述他自己的超然地位。
And he describes the importance of cultivating transcendental knowledge by approaching a spiritual master.
Krishna 在第四章描述了，就是通过接近一位灵性导师，培养超然知识的重要性。
And then in the fifth chapter, Krishna is describing Karma Yoga action in Krishna consciousness.
到了第五章，Krishna就继续形容。
So the Karma Yogi has got more knowledge now, and he's able to work with that knowledge in Krishna consciousness.
那么这样呢，这些Karma Yogi，这些业报瑜伽师，他们到此呢就拥有了更多的知识，这样呢，他们就可以在Krishna知觉当中呢履行工作了。
So we know there's a yoga ladder. There's a yoga ladder. At the bottom of the yoga ladder is karmakanda, material fruit of activities.
有一个瑜伽阶梯，这瑜伽阶梯的最底部是karmakanda，是果报工作。
And then above karmakanda, you have karma yoga.
在karmakanda 之上呢是karma yoga.
And above karma yoga, you have jnana yoga.
在karma yoga上之上的是jnana yoga.
So usually people who do jnana yoga, they don't work, they stop work.
通常那些做Jnana Yoga的练Jnana Yoga的，他们就不工作了，他们停止了工作。But
you see, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna's encouraging action. He wants Arjuna to work. He's not encouraging people to give up work. He wants people to work. He wants Arjuna to fight. Arjuna wanted to give up. He didn't want to fight, but Krishna wants him. Krishna wants action.
但是在《国家梵歌》当中呢，我们看到 Krishna 他是鼓励Arjuna去工作的，他不希望Arjuna放弃他的工作。Arjuna本来是想放弃，但是 Krishna 希望Arjuna活动。
So Krishna speaks karma yoga, action in Krishna consciousness.
因此在第五章 Krishna 就描述了在 Krishna 知觉当中的活动的 karma yoga.
And he speaks this after giving transcendental knowledge.
他是在给予了超人知识之后，讲述了这一点。
So you work, but work with detachment. And if you work with knowledge, then it's even better.
所以人应当工作，但是应当怀着气绝心去工作，最好是在知识当中去工作。
Okay.
自性，佛教专用词，明心见性。有人说本我、真我、如来藏等等。自性，你说的是真我的话，我就把它理解成灵魂。自性本我，是那个原来没有被污染的真我。这样看来，自性是不是就指灵魂呢？ So, different devotee give the opinion about how the term 自性 means. Somebody says that 自性 means that Atma, the true self that is not polluted, that is the true self, and that means the soul. So this devotee who raised the question didn't say and.
Wants to know what is the relationship between the mind and the true self?
And also false ego. Yes.
And also false ego.
Yes. Yes.
Well, the mind is the subtle body, right? And we carry our mind with us from the previous life. So we bring the mind actually carries us into another body. And according to the desire, the things which are in our mind, it will bring us to another body in the material world.
就把我们带到另外一具躯体当中，就是在前世当中呢，这个心意就把这个我们带到下一个躯体当中，就根据我们的愿望，它就在物质世界，心意携带着我们进入另一个躯体。Desires
are in the mind.
愿望就储藏在心意里。The desire.
When we desire to enjoy the material world separate from Krishna, then that keeps us in the material world.
们想要独立于 Krishna 之外来享受物质世界的时候，来享受的时候，这种愿望就使得我们持续不断的驻留在物质世界。
So when the mind is absorbed in thought of material enjoyment and sense gratification, then it's the cause of bondage. But if the same mind is absorbed in thought of Krishna, then it can bring about our liberation.
当心意专注于物质享乐，专注于感官享乐的时候，就会带来束缚。当心意专注于 Krishna 的时候，就会带来解脱。
False ego is the mood that I am the doer, or that I am the proprietor, and this belongs to me, and it's for my enjoyment.
假我就是这种心态，就是我是活动者，我是作为者，这属于我，应该由我来享受。
So the false ego is also part of the subtle body, and it accompanies the mind along with intelligence.
假我也是精微躯体的一部分，它是由心意和智性陪伴着。
The false ego tells us I'm the body, and my body is for enjoying.
假我就在那里说，我就是个躯体，然后这个躯体就是应该用来享受的。
So there is pure ego.The pure ego is to understand I am not the body, I am a soul, and my soul is the servant of Krishna.
除了假我之外，还有一个真我，一个纯粹的自我。纯粹的自我就告诉我们，我不是这个躯体，我是灵魂，而且我是 Krishna 的仆人。
So the mind and the false ego, along with intelligence,They make up the subtle body, and that subtle body covers the soul, and depending on the consciousness of the subtle body will determine where we take our birth in the material world.
心意、假我和智性就组成了精微的躯体，它覆盖了灵魂，就根据这个精微躯体的知觉程度，决定了我们下一个出生。
So when we control our mind, give up material desire, and use the mind to think about devotional service, then we can begin to cultivate higher consciousness. Spirit, we can come towards the spiritual consciousness.
当我们控制了心意，放弃物质的愿望的时候，让心意想着奉爱服务，这就能帮助我们培养知识，培养灵性了。
OK.
He asked, is that the mind dominate over over our soul?Maybe you have already explained that, and also he asked, is that the mind and the soul decide the size of the false ego, and is that the percentage between the three is?
Well, I can't give you any figures because it's going to vary for every individual. It's going to be different for everybody. It's not the same, you know? You can't say, no. So it depends how much your mind is absorbed in sense gratification and the level of your sense gratification. How gross is your sense gratification?
就是因人而异的，这个取决于您的心意是在多大程度上想着专注于感官享乐，然后感官享乐的层面是如何的，以及它的粗糙程度。
Some people are more attached to sense gratification than others.
某些人对感官享乐的程度，依恋程度要超过其他的人。
And some people's sense gratification is more degrading and more disgusting than others.
而且有的人的感官享乐是比别的人更加的低级、粗俗，更加的令人厌恶。
And false ego, again, false ego is also, you know, going to be depending on how much you're influenced by the different modes of nature. Some people are more in ignorance, some are more in passion, and some are more in goodness.
至于假我呢，也取决于这个受物质自然属性的影响程度。有的人更加就是处于愚昧属性，有的人更加处于激情，有的人处于善良。
And there's always a fluctuation of the modes of nature. Sometimes the mode of goodness isn't over everything, and sometimes the mode of passion, sometimes the mode of ignorance. They conquer each other. It's not stable.
而且物质自然三属性是相互竞逐的，有的时候善良占上风，有的时候激情善风也占上风，有的时候愚昧属性占上风，它们不是稳定的。
But the point is how to get free from these things, and the solution is to become Krishna conscious, surrender to Krishna.
关键是怎么摆脱这些事情，解决的方案就是 Krishna 之觉，要臣服 Krishna.
Train the mind.
要训练心意。
Train the mind to surrender to Krishna, to give up material desires, and to instead of desiring for sense gratification, to desire for the service of Krishna.
训练心意臣服，放弃物质的欲望，放弃感官享乐，让心意来臣服，来做服务，臣服 Krishna.
Understand, we're not the enjoyer, we're not the supreme.We're not the center of the universe.
要明白，我们并非享乐者，我们并非至尊主宰，我们并非宇宙的中心。
We're tiny, insignificant souls struggling in the material energy.
我们是微不足道、渺小的灵魂，在物质存在当中苦苦挣扎着。
Okay.
下来最后一个是毛毛。亲爱的 Gurudev， 听你讲课说两个小时念完十六圈，可我总是一会儿念诵快，一会儿慢，有时候就两个多小时，有时候一个半小时念完，总是无法两个小时完成。是要匀速念，还是可以只要两个小时念完就可以了呢？Dear Gurudev, in your lecture you said that we should channel finish our 16 rounds within 2 hours, but sometimes my chant is quick, but sometimes it's slow. Sometimes it's more than 2 hours, sometimes it's 1.5 hours. I cannot exactly finish it in 2 hours. Is that we should chant in a regular space, or that we...finish our rounds within 2 hours, that is okay.
It doesn't matter how long you take. You may take 3 hours, no problem. It doesn't matter. But you should chant at least 2 hours, minimum 2 hours. If you finish in 1.5 hours, then you chant more, because you should chant at least for 2 hours a day.
就是时间不是问题，多长时间念完，就是十六圈，你念3个小时也没问题，但是至少要念2个小时。如果您是一个半小时就念完的话，那您就应该继续念诵，要至少念2个小时，念诵的时间要至少2小时。
But you can chant much more if you like. Chant 5 hours and 8 hours, no problem.
但是您可以。念诵的时间达到5个小时或者8个小时都没问题。
Yes. Okay.
Another question. Do you have time?
Uh huh.
Shrita Sakhi Dasi, Hare Krishna and my Guru, 我没有强烈的愿望回归，我觉得回归是Krishna说的算，我只是很好的做服务，努力修行就好。但在和负面人讨论的时候，都说你要有强烈的愿望回归，不能不想。或者我的想法、我的问题，感谢Guru，感谢Guru两个组。 Hare Krishna, I don't have strong desire to go back to Godhead. I feel that it is the matter Krishna will decide. And for myself, I only do my service and I can try to practice. But when I discuss this point with devotees, they said that you should have strong desire to go back home, back to Godhead. You shouldn't neglect this desire. So I don't know whether my idea is there's any problem with my idea or not.
Well, so long as you're fully engaged in Krishna's service, that's the main thing.
只要您是全就是百分之百的从事奉爱服务，这是最主要的事情。
You're not thinking about going back to Godhead just now. Maybe later in life you'll think about it.
也许您现在不想回归神手这件事，也许在您。
You're already back to Godhead because you're chanting Hare Krishna and serving Krishna here. So you're already back to Godhead.
您已经回归神手了，因为您在这里唱诵 Hare Krishna，也在服务着，所以您已经是回归了。Hare
Krishna.
Somebody asked about the price of a Gita. He said that previously it is more than 100 yuan, but now the price is cheaper. 现在不再放歌，好多价格啊！原来卖一百，卖我100多块，现在接下来请出怎么选择呀？价格便宜呀！现在请出怎么选择？便宜。
No, Krishna is giving you special mercy. Make the Bhagavad Gita cheaper so you can buy more books and give them away to people. I hope you're not complaining, are you? Yes, Krishna gave us a very low price. We're very lucky. So distribute more books. Okay, Ganshiya Sayura Function is a linking woman Ganshiya Guru Mani Gay Woman Gentai the Funny Ganshiya Sayura Function is a T1 linking Jufu Niman Shangha Kwaila Ikadasi Kwaila Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
非常感谢圣巴迪维纳什纳。